I'm going to begin playing Resident Evil 7 with the PlayStation VR. Now, I explained in the Wiki preview last night why I'm doing this as secondary sessions and I'm not streaming it. But just for the sake of reiteration, quickly here, I'll explain to you why I'm not doing this as live streams during the course of the week. There's two reasons. Alright, number one, because I've already live streamed this game once. I don't think there's going to be a significant audience of people who are going to want to come and watch me replay the exact same game in VR, especially because I'm not promising a full playthrough. What I want to do is get a few hours in of Resident Evil 7 in VR to do a comparison, but I don't want to replay the entire game. Number two, because when you use the PlayStation VR, you have to take frequent breaks. At least I have to take frequent breaks. The longest I think I've played the PSVR without taking a break was like maybe 30 minutes. For many reasons. Number one, because it's disorienting. Sometimes it causes motion sickness. Number two, because it causes that
sweat, right?
You know what I mean? That sweat that happens, it builds up on my, at least for me, under my eyes and on my cheeks when I'm wearing the thing. And it is pretty annoying. That kind of is where the technology is right now, that they haven't designed this thing to sit more comfortably on the head and not create this condensation and create uncomfortable feeling on the face, all right? So being that I'm going to probably have to take a few minutes break every, you know, 20 minutes or so, what kind of a stream would that be where, okay, 20 minutes of gameplay, now everyone just sit here for 5 minutes while I try to, you know, take the thing off and relax to get my eyes better, you know, not messed up and
get the sweat off my face.
And then, oh, no, I'll go back again. You know, it would be a pretty shitty stream in my opinion. So that being said, I don't know if I want to insanely flood the channel, especially because, again, I've already played Resident Evil 7. I already got a full playthrough up of it. And I'm not even committing to doing a second playthrough of Resident Evil 7 with the VR. I just kind of want to do a comparison. So maybe what I should do is just save the videos and then end up using that footage for the edited video that I want to make for KO Gaming later this week. Or should I upload them anyway? What do you think? That's kind of the question I'm posing to everyone. You know, last night I made a video on the King Hate Vlogs regarding a status update regarding my business, alright? I'm not going to go into detail whatsoever. I'm just going to say if you want to know how things are going, please check out that video. It goes into a lot of detail about things that I'm doing personally and things that is going on with the business. Lots of stuff that I'm trying to do to keep this afloat, alright? You know.
Admittedly, some people take it the wrong way, which is stupid because if the name of the video is that I'm going to give you a status update on the business and you watch the video, it's your own fault if you watched a business update and you're like, feels like Phil just made a video about this recently. Yes, this would be an update to that. If you don't care, why are you watching the video? Because some people are just really fucking dirt dumb. I don't know what else to say.
They watch videos just to be stupid and negative, rather than, you know, using common sense. Gee, it's a vlogging channel, and Phil made a vlog about the status of his business. Well, I don't care about that, so I'll skip it. No, they must watch it and complain. Whatever. But anyway, thanks to those who did watch the video, who did give constructive criticism, constructive suggestions. Thanks to those who obviously are trying to help me out via pledging via Patreon, via subbing here on Twitch, cheers on Twitch, everything, okay?
So please, 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 pledge to my Patreon.
Oh, you know what? Fens the Spook just made a good suggestion. He says he thinks that people who cheer like 500 bits of cheers or more a month should maybe be in on like you get a perk, right? Like, you get perks for bits and cheering. Listen, it would be nice, right? The problem is, there's no way to do that. Twitch doesn't have a listing of bits. There's, like, no way, there's no page, there's no report where I could pull up, oh, here's everyone who cheered in the month of January, right? And here's how much they cheered cumulatively. And there, now you can assign those people to get their questions answered on Ask the King. That doesn't exist right now. It would be nice. I definitely certainly would like that. But it doesn't exist. Hell, even on, I mean, I'll be honest, even on Patreon.
It's a pain in the ass to kind of keep track of people who are pledging. It's kind of a really annoying manual process.
It seems to me like a lot of these businesses, a lot of these businesses have great ideas, and then they implement them, but they don't implement them, like, to their fullest effect. Patreon. They file all your information. Let's say you did a $5 pledge for the month of January, okay? There's a spreadsheet that I can actually get from Patreon at the end of January that'll say, here's who pledged what in January. But the spreadsheet is a manual spreadsheet. It doesn't even allow me to say, for example, send messages to people automatically who pledged $5 and say, here's your $5 perk. It doesn't allow me to go to the $20 patrons and say, please, here's where you can post up your questions for Ask the King. None of that exists. It's all completely manual. So I have to sit there and go through the entire list of patrons for January
and manually click
on people's names, and I have to type out these manual messages and send everyone manual private messages on Patreon because they have no automated process to do anything. It's all manual work. It takes hours to do it, okay? Same thing on Twitch, right? Where people are cheering with bits all the time. That's great, right? People are subbing. That's great. But guess what? There's no actual way for me to pull up a listing of who's subbed or who's cheered. I actually tried to request a list of who's subbed about 2 weeks into it,
and I never even got it. They never sent it to me.
So it's very, very manual. It's really ridiculous, in my opinion.